For a long time, female students of Kabuya Seed Secondary School in Kabuya Sub-County, Chikube District have been walking for as long as 15 kilometers to and from school. As a result, many would fall prey to defilers and other distractions. To end this, the government through the Office of the Prime Minister and the World Bank have constructed a multi-million dormitory with solar energy that will accommodate 50 female students. Haja Tausi Kutusa, the head teacher, said girls' enrollment and performance is expected to improve because of the new milestone.
Moving long distances from their places. They were moving long distances to school. Some were coming from as far as Maya Sea, which is around 7 miles from here. Maya Kavira, which is also about 5 miles. Kisaru, and along the way, automatically, they met a number of challenges. Some border men would offer them a lift, and in the process, they would conceive and drop out of school.
The girls' dormitory with water, solar energy, stairs, latrine, and bathrooms accommodates 56 girls and was built to the Ministry of Education standard. Hajat Tau Sikutusa, the school head teacher, says that the school had suffered a high dropout rate because many girls in the surrounding villages of Maya, Kavira, and Chisaru walk over 14 miles to and from school.
Stereo is supposed to accommodate around at least 56 girls. That is by the Ministry of Education standards. Currently, the students are still reporting. The senior ones are not yet here. So as we talk, we have around 40 students so far who have reported.
Okay.
Tausi also requested the government and development partners to build a boys' dormitory because they also trek several miles to and from the school. Apart from the school dormitory, an outpatient unit with solar energy and water tanks was also constructed at Kabuya Health Center 3. Jerivazio Mohanji, the health center in charge, said the services at the facility have greatly improved since they started using them 3 years ago.
And also, what you need the HTS services, those who are supposed to go for HIV testing services, they also get screened from that point, and those who come here to see the clinician and direct also screen them from that point. Initially, we didn't have that space, so we are mixing up things and patients, so all categories were being mixed up, of which it was compromising our services, but as of now, yeah, services are being done the way they are supposed to be done because of this open structure.
Mohanji called for more support to improve maternity services at the health center. Development Response to Displacement Impact Project is a flagship Government of Uganda project funded by the World Bank, being implemented under the Office of the Prime Minister to address the effects of hosting refugees. Story compiled by Ambrose Niwagabaka Toto for the news.